Hello everyone. Today we are going to see a new topic called media access control. So before going into media access control, we need to know the two sublayers we have in data link layer. So we have two sublayers. One is data link control layer, other one is multiple access resolution or multiple access layer. So what is the purpose of these two sublayers in data link controllers, data link layer is, this data link control, what it will do is it will coordinate when two nodes wants to connect through point to point. So when point to point access is done between the two nodes, this data link control layer will take care of. So when multiple nodes exist, they want to talk to each other, they want to communicate through the through a common medium. So there is a common medium where all this nodes wants to transmit. In that case, we need a layer to coordinate the activities. That layer is called multiple access resolution, or we can call it as media access control sublayer. So this media access control sublayer will coordinate access to all the broadcast. So this is the purpose of media access control layer. So coming to this multiple, the protocols the required for the multiple access layer is, so these are the protocols we require. So it is divided into three categories. One is random access protocol. The second one is controlled medium access protocol, and third is channelization protocols. Okay, so coming to this random access protocol, we have four protocols. One is Aloha, second one is CSMA, next is CSMA/CD, the last one is CSMA/CA. Okay, so Aloha, carrier sense multiple access, carrier sense multiple access collision detection, carrier sense multiple access collision avoidance. Okay, next in controlled medium access protocols, we have three protocols are available. One is reservation method, second one is polling, and third one is token passing. So these are the protocols, techniques which will be seeing in controlled access protocol. Next is channelization protocol. Channelization protocols, we have FDMA, frequency division multiple access, TDMA, time division multiple access. Next is CDMA, code division multiple access. So we will be seeing all these protocols in this chapter. So in media access control, what is the purpose of media access control is, it will coordinate the access to the broadcast link. So whenever multiple nodes share a common medium, so the we need to coordinate. There is layer which is required for coordinating the activities of sending the medium, sending the data into the network. So in that case, we need this layer. That layer is called multiple access resolution layer. So these are the protocols which are required for doing all these activities. Okay. Now first we will see the topic on random access protocol. So what is random access protocol is, when a data, that is like when node or station, when node or we can call it as a station, wants to communicate with other node or station, okay, so it randomly, that is like it takes its own time, it will send the frame. When two or three nodes or stations are sharing the same common medium, in this case, like any node is not controlled by any other node. That is, any station is not controlled by any other station, and any station is not superior to one another, and it is not controlled over the other. So any station, if it is willing, if it is having the data, it can send the data or at its own time. So what is random access protocol, random access method in this case is, the transmission is random among the stations. So the transmission is random. Transmission is done randomly. So whenever it want, whenever it receives the data, it will send that particular time. It will not wait for other station to, it will not wait for other station to get its control. So it will take its own time and it will send the data. Randomly, it will send the data. So that is called random access protocols. So if at the same time, any other station is also willing to send the data, so what happens is that at that particular time, collision occurs. That collision will occur and it will both the frames will get lost. So this is one of the disadvantage we have in random access protocols. But we will see what are the methods we are going to, techniques we are going to follow to avoid collision. So the first method we are going to see is Aloha. Aloha was introduced at the University of Hawaii in 1970. Okay, this was designed for radio LAN. It was designed for radio LAN purpose. This Aloha was designed. First, we will see when a station wants to send data, another station also wants to send the data at the same time, data will get collided. Okay, so that is one of the cases in case of this particular when we are going to use the same common medium. But now we will see a pure Aloha where it is one type of original Aloha protocol. It is very elegant protocol. Here, whenever each station they want to send a frame, whenever it wants to send, it can use any one of the channel and it can send the frame. So for example, if you see in this station, there are four stations, they everyone are sharing the same common medium, but here I have drawn it separately, but they are going to share the same common medium. Suppose every station wants to send two frames, totally eight frames are available. First, station one, it is sending at time t and it is sending one more frame at this particular time. And station 2, it is sending here and it is also sending two frames here. Station 3 is sending at this time and also it is sending here. 4, it is sending this particular time and this is sending here. So what happens over here is, if you see only this particular case, the collision occurs. See, if you see this is a medium in which the same time in which all the stations are communicating. So what happens is all the frames will get collided and they will get lost. And here also this particular medium, in this particular case also, this frames and these two frames will get collided and they will get lost. Only this frame and this frame will go and reach the receiver. Okay, when the frame reaches the receiver has to send the acknowledgement. So the receiver has to send the acknowledgement back to the sender. Okay, when the receiver does not send the acknowledgement on time, that is like it will be, sender will have a timer, it will be fixed. When the receiver is not sending the acknowledgement within this particular time, the sender, what it will do is it will again resend the frame. It will resend the frame. Okay, it will resend the frame to the receiver. So at the same time, any other sender also wants to resend the frame, there also collision may occur. Okay, so here there is a time called back off time. What do you mean by back off time? Is that is represented by TB. So what do you mean by that is, like whenever it re, like if it is the receiver is not sending the acknowledgement within that particular time, so the sender, it will wait for some random time. That random time is called back off time. It will wait for this particular time randomly, it will wait for some time, after which it will start resending the frame to the receiver. This time is called as back off time, or it may be TB. So the randomness, like each station they will wait for a random amount of time before it is resending the frame. This time is called as back off time. So each sender will wait for random amount of time. Will wait for random amount of time before resending. Before resending the frame. This time is called as back of time or TB. So in case of Aloha, we are seeing pure Aloha, where which like they whenever they receive the data, they will start sending the frame through the common medium. So at the same time, any other station also sending the same media, same data at that particular time, the collision occurs. And when the frames reach properly to the receiver, sender expects acknowledgement from the receiver. Receiver will send the acknowledgement, and the sender does not receive the acknowledgement within the time slot. So what it will do is it will resend the frame. So it will wait for some random amount of time and it will start resending the frame. This time is called as back of time, that is represented. Now we will see the procedure for pure Aloha with the flowchart. So first we will go for start station. If a station wants to send a frame, that is a station wants to send a frame, okay, so initially the K will be equal to 0. K is nothing but it is the number of attempt it is going to send the frame. Initially it is sending it the first time, so we will set K to be 0. Then now what happens is the station will send the frame now. So after sending it, it will wait for some time, that is it will wait for 2 into T to the power of P. What is TP? Is TP is nothing but maximum propagation time. So here maximum propagation time is the time required for reaching a frame from the sender to the receiver, and again we have to receive the acknowledgement. So it will wait for twice into propagation time. After waiting, what happens is if the acknowledgement has been received properly. So if acknowledgement has been received within this particular time, so it will go for success. If acknowledgement has been received properly, if it is true, it goes for success. That means like it properly, the frame has been reached to the receiver. No, if it is acknowledgement has not been received within this time slot, so we have to go for one more attempt of resending the frame. So K will be equal to K plus 1 now. So again, so it will, now it will check for the condition. If the K is greater than K max, there is a maximum level up to which you can resend the frame. Usually K max will be the value 15, that is you can make 15 attempts. So if the K value, if it reaches K max, then if it is true means then you have to abort, you should not resend the frame, you should stop sending the frame. Or if it is lesser than this value, it will wait for some random time. This random time is nothing but you have to choose this value between 0 to 2 to the power of K minus 1. So you have to choose a random value 0 to 2 to the power of K minus 1, and you have to calculate this TB. That is your back of time. How would you calculate this back of time? That is TB will be this R value into propagation time. That is nothing but your back of time. So what you have to do, you have to choose a random value between 0 to 2 power k minus 1. That R value into this propagation time will give you the back of time. So back of time is nothing but time we have to wait before resending the frame, the amount of time you have to wait. No, that is TB will be calculated with random value into TP. So once you wait for some time and after TB, then you start resending the frame. So again what happens, you will resend the frame, and again you wait for some time to get the acknowledgement, and if the acknowledgement has received, it is success, or otherwise you go for next attempt. So if it reaches K max, you abort it, or otherwise choose a random time and you choose some value between this and you multiply this with propagation time, you'll get TB. So you wait for this particular TB time in the sender and start resending the frame. This process will goes on until it becomes success, or otherwise until it reaches the maximum maximum attempt is done. So here K is nothing but number of attempt, and TP is maximum propagation time. TFR is average transmission time for a frame, and TB is back of time. That will be calculated with the formula, that is like it is called as binary exponential back of, that is nothing but R into TP. Okay, exponential back of time, that is nothing but R into TP. Okay, you understood this pure Aloha method. You have to draw this diagram and you have to explain with this procedure for pure Aloha. Next, we will see the vulnerable time for pure Aloha protocol. What is vulnerable time? Vulnerable time is nothing but the length of time in which there is a possibility of collision. There is a possibility of collision. So what is the length of time in which there is a possibility of collision is called vulnerable time. Suppose, for example, if the station A is sending the frame at this particular time and station B is sending at this time, there is a collision occurs at this end of the frame, at the end of sending A frame. Okay, so we can say that the vulnerable time is nothing but it is the twice the frame transmission time. So it takes twice the frame transmission time. Within this, there is if any other station is trying to send the frame, definitely there will be a collision. So what is vulnerable time? Vulnerable time during which a collision may occur in pure Aloha is twice the frame transmission time. Okay, this is the vulnerable time for pure Aloha protocol. But the time is more, it is very large. So for that, we are going for the next protocol called slotted Aloha. Next, we will see slotted Aloha. Pure Aloha, they have a vulnerable time of twice into frame transmission time. To reduce that particular time, we are going for slotted Aloha. In slotted Aloha, what we are going to do is we are going to divide the time into slots. So for example, you are dividing into equal slots. So this is slot number 1, slot 2, slot 4, slot 5 and slot 6. Okay, so we are dividing into equal slots each of time TFR. So each is having a time of TFR seconds. So suppose, for example, here if a station wants to send the frame, they can send the frame only at the beginning of the slot. In between the slot, they cannot able to send. Suppose station 1 is sending the frame here. Okay, and another frame they should not send in between. They can send at the next time slot only. So it is sending the frame here. Station B is sending the frame here, and then it is sending the frame here. And station C, it is sending the frame in the second time slot and at the last time slot. And station 4 is sending the frame at third time slot and then in the fifth time slot. So what happens over here is, so here the one of the advantages what we have done is, like, stations cannot send in between the time slot. They should send only at the beginning of this time slot. So because of doing like this, more collisions can be avoided. So if you see, this is the part where the collision occurs. But we can able to send these many frames from the sender to the receiver. Okay, this is a part where the collision occur. This both the station are sending the frame at the same time. Here also they are sending at the same time. So the collision occurs at this particular time and the collision occurs here also. And but the frames have reached, so this frame and the frame over here have reached the destination properly. Okay, this is the procedure for slotted Aloha. In slotted Aloha, we are going to divide it into equal time slots, so each station can send the frame only at the beginning of this time slot. They cannot send in between, so we can able to avoid some collision because of this time slots. Okay, so you will see the vulnerable time for slotted Aloha. Suppose a station A is sending the frame here and station B is sending the frame at time T and station C is also sending the frame at time T. So this, there will be a collision occurs at this particular time. So we can say that vulnerable time is only TFR. Vulnerable time will be equal to the frame transmission time. So the time has been reduced from 2FR to simply TFR in case of slotted Aloha. So what happens over here is vulnerable time will be only TFR for slotted Aloha. So in this video, we have seen the two types of Aloha. One is pure Aloha, the one is slotted Aloha. In pure Aloha, whenever the station is free, it will start sending the frame, and there may be so many collisions may occur in pure Aloha. So for that, we are going for slotted Aloha, in which we are going to divide the time into slots. So each station can send the frame only at the beginning of the slot. So because of this, some collisions can be avoided, but still there is a possibility of collisions. So the vulnerable time for this slotted Aloha is TFR. Okay, thank you.